Back then, everything went through Frank. The plans, the orders, the money. You could get the call day or night.
Ah, Tommy. Frank says to wait for him in the garage out in the back. Eh? You got the job, I think.
Thanks, Luigi. Sarah's cooking. She's bringing something over.
In this rain? She's a good girl.
I'll see you tomorrow, Luigi.
Yeah, sure. Back in the day, when the boss was still with that phone, we got called out to a hit. Some politician on the take. Now this storm's just raging, right? And we're driving out to the burbs to cap this guy. The street lights weren't so good, so we're driving in the dark. We get to the house, and we're about to make our move. Then there's this lightning flash, and for a split second, in the front yard, I see this head just sitting there, staring, cut off at the neck.
Nah, this ain't true.
Some other crew had already been out to the house that night. Guess the guy had more than his share of enemies. They never found the body.
Bullshit.
God's truth.
Hey, Tommy. You good?
Yeah. Wet, but good.
Thanks for waiting, Tom. The Don and I had to go over last month's numbers again.
Sure. So what's the job?
I want you to help Sam and Polly with the shipment we've got coming in tonight.
The good stuff?
Straight from Canada.
Where do you need me?
Sam's gone to meet our friends from the north at a farm outside of town. Polly will oversee the trucks bringing the shipment into the city, but I want you to go with him. Be an extra pair of eyes. Make sure it all goes smoothly.
Okay.
Get the car from Ralphie and meet Paulie at the warehouse. He's got heaters in case you run into any trouble.
Sure, Frank. No problem.
Good. Now bring the Canadian home safe, Tommy. There is already a case earmarked for the Don.
This mama motor is yours, if you want it, Tommy.
Thanks, Ralph.
Now brings you a special weather report. The heavens have opened, folks, and we're experiencing some adverse effects across the municipal area. A large storm front, not expected to arrive for several days, hit Lost Heaven late this afternoon, releasing a deluge of rainfall on the city. If you've been out in the last couple of hours, you don't need me to tell you. There are reports coming in of a number of traffic accidents attributed to the downpour, with fender benders occurring in Oakwood and Chinatown. A more serious accident has occurred near the White Harbor Hotel, which is causing traffic to back up on the East Marshall Bridge all the way into downtown. The police department is attending incidents as they can, but they've now issued advice that people should not venture out on the roads unless their journey is strictly necessary. The roads are treacherous, ladies and gentlemen, so however a good driver you may be, it's just not worth the risk to you or anyone else. It would seem the best thing to do on a night like this is to stay at home with your loved ones and keep warm and dry. I know where I'd rather be on a night like this. In addition to the problems we've been hearing of on the roads, air traffic in and out of the city has been suspended by order of the Aviation Authority. All scheduled flights departing Lost Heaven International have been grounded, and those scheduled to arrive into that airport have been canceled or diverted elsewhere. Now, as bad as that may sound, the latest report from the weather service that I've just been handed states that although the rain is heavy at this moment and that all warnings should be heeded, The storm isn't expected to last all that long. Certainly, it doesn't seem like it will be anything like the big one of 1927. High winds are pushing the storm over us at quite a rate. We will, of course, keep you informed with news on the hour. But before I return you to our musical programming, let me reiterate that the Lost Heaven Police Department strongly advises against motor travel at this time. And on a personal note, I advise staying with your family, friends, or loved ones and waiting out this dreadful storm in the warmth of the home. That's all for now. Some music will be along shortly, and I'll be back to check in with you later. Thank you for listening. Scheduled music programs and regular news bulletins brought to you by Lost Heaven Radio.
Come on, Tom! Hey, hey! Watch it, pal. Just dry it out.
Sorry. You know this place?
Yeah. We've done a few pickups at the farm before. Don't worry. There ain't nothing but cow shit and shine out here. It's gonna be an easy few clams. Boys will load up the trucks, and we'll come straight back.
Yeah, let's make it quick. I got someplace to be.
You see it, Sarah, later. Luigi's little girl, your night shift. You're something else, pal. Protecting the girl's virginity one day and taking it the next.
Lay off, Polly.
Ah, come on. I'm just kidding. She's a good girl. You settle down, she'll straighten you right out. You're going home to a couch. Now, I wonder what kind of story she could tell about her old man, though. Luigi was a stone-cold killer back in the day.
I wouldn't know.
You know she's been helping out behind the bar since she was a kid. I bet she's seen and heard a few things. Probably knows more about our business than we do.
She knows enough not to ask me too many questions.
That's good. She won't ever make a liar out of you. Christ. You ought to marry her just for that. God damn it. Sam should be waiting here, but I don't see him.
Something smells off.
Don't let your pecker get all shriveled up. Probably just trying to get out of the rain. Or into the bootleg. That'll wake him.
He ain't coming.
Okay. Let's go find him. That bastard is just three sheets, and I'm wrecking a new suit for nothing. I swear I'm gonna kill him. Here. Just in case Frank was right. I'm gonna go grab them boys, get them sorted out. You go ahead, see what's what. We'll catch up with you.
Waiting here tonight. Guy we pay to keep this place in check. Don't even pretend to farm her.
hell are you hiding?
Hey, buddy. Jesus.
Drop your weapon.
You first.
We don't have time for this.
Sorry, pal. Guess we're doing this the hard way.
Okay, then.
Get over here! I got him pinned down!
No room for punks like you in.
Over here!
Tom!
Polly! What took you so long?
We're looking for Sammy. Did you find him?
Nah, not yet. Just him.
Canadian crew. Dollars to donuts to rest the face down in the dirt, too. Oh, Christ. Cops, Tommy.
Well, how would I know? They didn't show a badge. God, they didn't say anything.
They must be in Morello's pocket. This bastard. He can't even let us have this one racket. Forget about it, Tom. We gotta find Sam and get out of here.
These guys are the real deal. They gotta be cops from the Border Patrol.
Search the farm, find Sam, get the hell out. Anyone else, we slip them the bump. Get it?
Canadians. See Sam in there?
No.
Like some.
Poor bastards.
There!
They killed him! Hey! Hey! Over here!
Grab me cover!
Dang it, dead bastard!
Border cops doing Morello's dirty work.
Fellas, push through!
Tommy, look out! Doctor, look out! Tommy, look out! Some new crew's joining up! Hit the metal glove!
Stay here and watch our backs. Plug anyone who gets within 100 yards. Except us.
Hey, Polly.
Tammy. Oh, Jesus.
What have they done to you? I got clipped. Grace has a lot of blood.
Can you walk?
No, I don't think so.
Okay. Just hang on. I'll go get the truck, then we'll take you to the doctor. Hey, you're gonna make it, Sam. Tommy, stay here with him. I'll be back in a flash.
Okay.
Fuck!
Hey, it'll be okay, Sam. We survived worse.
You sure we have?
Tony and Donnie too?
Yeah.
What a fucking massacre. How's Sam?
Well, he ain't any worse.
I'll go get him. Keep an eye out.
Okay.
Hey, we're gonna get y'all patched up. Okay?
Polly? We got more company.
All right, get in.
Okay. I'm right here, Sam.
There's some ammo and a Thompson back there somewhere. When they pull in behind you, blast them to hell. Just don't let them get past us.
That thing back there is huge! Where the hell did they find that truck?
You like that, you bear! Take him out now!
Let him have it!
Good night, asshole!
You think we're okay now? Do you? We're in trouble, Tom! Keep going, Tommy!
These guys keep on coming! Polly,
there's no fall trucks! Taking too much fire!
Polly, faster!
My pedal is to the metal! Did we lose them?
Two squad cars on us!
We're in trouble, Tom!
They're right on our ass!
We're in trouble, Tom! Now, Tom!
I got more where that came from!
Holly, we gotta lose him!
We did it! We did it!
Okay, we're here. Tom, you get Sam out. I'm gonna go wake up the doc.
Sam. We made it. We're at the doctor's house.
Three, I owe you.
Paulie, what the hell are you doing here so late?
Evening, Doc. Sorry to wake you, but we had a little accident. We got an injured man out here.
All right, bring him inside.
Okay, thank you. Okay, I'll stay with Sam. You can take the truck back. Call it a night.
No, I'll wait.
The doc's already got his hands full. No sense in both of us breathing down his neck.
Go on, Doc. I'm gonna be fine.
Okay.
Hey. You did good tonight.
Of our series looking back over the president's plans and results since his inauguration.
While we are making this great common effort, there should be no discord and no dispute. This is no time to cavil or to question the standards set by this universal agreement. It is time for patience and understanding and cooperation. Workers of this country have rights under this law, which cannot be taken from them, and nobody will be permitted to whittle them away. But, on the other hand, no aggression is now necessary to attain those rights. The whole country will be united to get them for you. A principle that applies to the employers applies to the workers as well. And I ask you workers to cooperate in the same spirit. When Andrew Jackson, old Hickory, died, someone asked, will he go to heaven? The answer was, he will if he wants to. If I am asked whether the American people will pull themselves out of this depression, I answer, they will if they want to. The essence of the plan is a universal limitation of hours of work per week for any individual by common consent, and a universal payment of wages above the minimum, also by common consent. My friends, I cannot guarantee the success of this nationwide plan, but the people of this country can guarantee its success. I have no faith in cure-alls, but I believe that we can greatly influence economic forces. I have no sympathy with the professional economists who insist that things must run their course and that human agencies can have no influence on economic ills. Definition of economic laws every 5 or 10 years, for a very long time. But I do have faith, and retain faith, in the strength of common purpose, and in the strength of unified action taken by the American people.
The president there speaking earlier this year on the National Recovery Administration. WLH 570 Lost Heaven Radio brings you modern music and news bulletins throughout the day. Thank you for listening. There's a reason the racers of the Lost Heaven Grand Prix use only Traeger motor oil, and that's because only Traeger makes engines perform at their maximum while guarding against wear and tear. For optimal performance, Traeger lets you go, go, go.
You're late. Dinner's cold.
Work.
Hey, boss. I came as soon as I got your message.
Sit down, Tom. We have a mole, Tom.
No. Who?
I was up all night driving myself nuts trying to figure it out. I started thinking maybe it's one of our guys. We aren't paying his fair share. Someone with a light wallet.
Maybe looking to Marilla for a new suit.
Frank wasn't around, so I went to the safe to get the account books. To see who's getting cents on the dollar he's earned.
What do you know?
The books are gone, Tom.
Frank.
More than 50 years I've known him. Everything I have, I got with Frank. And every buck we've earned, every dime we've paid out, it's all logged in those books. Frank hands those over to the feds, we're finished.
Frank respects one person in this whole town, and that's you. This has got to be some kind of misunderstanding.
I've been calling him all day. I went by his place. He's gone. His wife and kid are gone.
But why?
I don't know. I'm sure he has his reasons. Maybe he's still smarting over the dog.
The one you tried to drown?
Yeah. Same one I shot after he wouldn't let me sink her. I was a stupid kid, Tommy. But grudge or no grudge, we gotta get those books back. Shake down all our stories. See who knows what. When you catch up to Frank, you get those books. And if he doesn't have them on him, you make him tell you where to find them. After that, you do what we gotta do.
Vincenzo's waiting for you with a clean car.
Tommy. Tough day today, Tom.
We gotta keep a lid on this, Tom. Start with Biff. Don't give him nothing. I got you a clean set of wheels. And something special here, if you want it. When Frank sees a LaPara, he'll know. The old ways work. I didn't see this coming now from Frank.
And now for the latest news. The Navy is today continuing its search for the remains of those brave souls lost aboard the airship USS Akron. The Akron was destroyed in a violent thunderstorm off the New Jersey coast Tuesday morning with the loss of 73 of 76 aboard. The disaster stands as the worst aviation accident on record. Yesterday, one of the survivors, Lieutenant Commander Herbert V. Wiley, spoke to members of the press and gave a brief account of the tragedy. He also spoke of the survivors' rescue by the German tanker, Phoebus. President Roosevelt has described the loss of the Akron as a national disaster and said that he grieves with the wives and...
Tommy, what's the rumpus?
Heard any big news lately? Something that Don might want to know.
It depends. What's it worth to you?
$20.
How about 40?
All right, spill.
The FBI is in town. They're getting something from Morello, but I don't know what.
How'd you hear?
Little Tony got some guy drunk in the Black Cat and drove him home. Heard a bunch of stuff, so he's the guy you want to see.
Okay. Thanks.
Always a pleasure, Tommy.
Sports report. There's a sense of anticipation as we await the start of the big game. Our very own Lost Heaven Lancers are out on the road, deep in enemy territory as they take on bitter rivals, the Empire Bay Cannons. This year's Gold Series is shaping up to be one of the best on record, with both teams matching one another blow for blow. Despite the Cannons' home field advantage and an early lead in the series, the Lancers have bounced back and have really taken their rivals to task. Many of the plaudits and column inches have been dedicated to one man. Lancers pitcher Bunny Smith is one of this year's standout performers. And with this series tied at 3-3, he may well be the key man that brings the Wistman Trophy back to Lost Heaven.
But doing so will be no easy task, as standing in his way is opposition captain Foghorn Jack Seidel. Game 6, and we now have a powder keg finale that is sure to have everyone glued to their radios. Can Bunny Smith bring it home for Lost Heaven? Or will the cannon's towering redhead have the final say? WLH 570 Lost Heaven Radio will carry live coverage of the final game of the Gold Series, and we hope you'll join us in wishing our boys well. And now, back to some of the latest musical numbers.
Everything okay, Tom?
Nah, it's not. What's this about the guy you drove home who's with the feds?
He came in for a drink, which turned into 10. He's hired muscle for some kind of safe house.
Where?
Oak Hill, corner of Pine. He gave me $10 to drive him back and keep my mouth shut. Let on that Councillor Gilatti's brokered some kind of deal between Morello and the FBI. They were all ready to sit tight on someone in there.
Why the hell didn't you tell us?
Tom, I did. I came in to see Frank straight away. He didn't tell the Don?
No, he didn't.
Tom, what's going on?
Now to the coverage of Game 7 of the Gold Series. And by the looks of it, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be underway any minute now. The crowd here in the Armory are restless. You can almost taste the tension as we approach this, the deciding game between these two famous rivals. More than a little bad blood between them, and more than a couple of nasty flare-ups in recent years. Of course, this occasion, more than any other, could prove feisty, what with the drama that closed out the previous game. That, of course, saw the Lancers win to tie the series, and it's not often Empire Bay and Lost Heaven can boast the game's best current hitter and pitcher, respectively. I refer, of course, to Foghorn Seidel, a man mountain with a shock of red hair, and Lancers star Bunny Smith. Speaking of Smith, he is jogging, I suppose you'd say, between his teammates, issuing last-minute orders. They seem responsive to whatever he's saying. He commands respect from his team, that is for sure. My goodness, there must be some nerves among some of the younger Lancers, Elms, Graveson, and Nicholson. Smith seemed to have pepped them up. That's good to see. That's what a good captain does. The Cannons lineup is meandering over to the home team dugout. The Lancers are slowly taking up their position, so we can't be too far away from the opening pitch here at the Armory, the home of the Empire Bay Cannons. Stay with us for more.
Like the place.
Take me to those account books, Frank.
And we return now to coverage what could be the final play of this game and the series between the Lost Heaven Lancers and the Empire Bay Cannons. A quick reminder that this final inning is being brought to you by Swift Cola. When you need a lift, reach for a Swift. It's not only a taste sensation, it's guaranteed to increase focus, drive, and mental clarity. Pick up a bottle of Swift Cola today. And as we are coming to a close, let me thank today's other sponsors, Big Break Cigarettes and Lost Heaven Courier. Both of these teams could be said to be entering golden eras. Each team has a star player at the core with promising youngsters set around them. I refer, of course, to Smith and Seidel. The Cannons have had several such golden periods. The Lancers, it's fair to say, have not. I can see Lancers manager Frankie Hodge prowling in front of the dugout, gesticulating. He seems animated, to say the least. Looks like he's putting one of the officials in his place or something or other. With the noise of the crowd, it is quite hard to say for sure. Whatever's going on down there, you can feel the sense of occasion, and you just know that whatever happens, the crowd will be the first to tell you what has happened. The Lancers are now within minutes of snatching the Gold Series, which at one stage had appeared doomed, but they equally teeter on the edge of defeat. It all comes down to the final play. Nobody is warming up in the bullpen. Nobody down there is considering the possibility of extra innings.
There could be some kind of meat happening.
Bunny Smith then, standing on the mound, a look of steely determination on his face. He's betraying no emotion, doesn't look nervous or tired after his exertions this series, nor does he appear to be carrying the weight of expectation. He's having a word with the umpire about something or other. What a strapping fellow. 6'2", 195 pounds. If the Lancers are to win here today, he's going to write himself into the record books. And boy, oh boy, what that would mean to the people of Lost Heaven after such a long time without glory on the diamond. All right, they've sorted out whatever was going on. Here we go then. In for the Cannons, it's Paddy Dougherty. Smith is pitching the game of his life, but Dougherty's a big man. If he can catch one, it could run, and with bases loaded, the Cannons would have it. Here we go. Dougherty facing down Smith. Fastball and strike. The big man thought he had it. Some speed on that
shit.
Ball. My goodness.
They've taken you to the airport, Frank.
Was a little spooked. He was convinced he had it. His body language tells the tale. Smith remains cool under pressure, not a flicker of emotion on his face. He winds up. And that's two. There was zip on that one. Good Lord. Seidel is barking something at Dougherty, but we have no chance of hearing it as the noise of the crowd reaches fever pitch. Dougherty's gesturing, and that's only making Seidel more irate. This is it, folks. Another strike, and the Lancers win. If Dougherty can get behind it, surely the Cannons will get all their men home and snatch victory. A swing and a miss, and that's the winners! Lancers win! Lancers win! And Smith finally cracks an elated smile. He's thrown his cap in the air. His teammates, Lancers win the 1933 Gold Series!
They're flying him out of state or something. Fuck, this ain't good.
Just flashed a badge at me and forced me out.
Hides will be canceled, I'm sure of it.
Thank you.
said we should go steady on you.
He's some kind of gangster. Why the hell isn't he being flown out by the feds?
Thank you.
Tom.
Frank. The Don sent me.
I figured as much. I'm sorry it had to be you, Tommy.
Anything you want me to tell him?
I wish it could have shaken out better, but Morello finally came after me. It's okay. You can come out. Morello offered me a simple trade. The Don's account books for our lives and tickets out of this town.
You hand the books over yet?
I'm not so stupid, Don. They're safe. Morello was waiting for this.
It's a key to a box in the Grand Imperial Bank downtown.
I told Morello I'd hand it over after the plane was fueled and ready to go. His men were meant to fetch it before we left.
I took care of him. Told him to get on a plane.
Go on, March. Alice, get aboard.
Frank, you're coming with us.
Not right now, honey. Just get buckled in. Tommy and I, we have some serious business to discuss.
But Frank...
Get on the plane, March. For Alice. For me. Get on the goddamn plane, please.
You been paid yet?
Yeah.
Now you've been paid twice. You take the ladies wherever they want to go.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Tom.
Christ, Frank. Why didn't you ask us for help?
I guess I just wanted out. One way or the other. I'm tired, Tommy. Tired of lying to my wife. Tired of checking under my car every time I take a Sunday drive. And tired of waiting for the Don to put two in my temple.
God damn you, Frank. Where's the safety deposit boxes?
With my colleague downstairs, sir.
Thanks.
Beautiful day, huh?
Uh-huh.
Keeping out of trouble, I hope.
I need to access the deposit boxes for Frank Coletti.
Ah, yes. Mr. Angelo?
Yeah.
Mr. Coletti said it might be you who came, and to provide access. Please, follow me.
Thank you.
I got the books and covered my tracks. Salieri never asked any questions. In fact, apart from the funeral, I never heard him talk about Frank again.
Making my boys twitchy, Marku.
Sergio and I just came by to pay respects, that's all. Known Frank a long time. Almost as long as you. He's a good man. Smart. Loyal. Loyal to his wife. His kid above all else. There must be some kind of honor in that in you.
Maybe. But I'm still looking at this headstone with his little girl's name on it.
It's a hell of a thing.
Look at these houses. Big yards. White picket fences. It's the American dream, eh, Tommy?
I suppose.
Not for you?
No, sir. I like being closer to the business.
Don't let the flower beds and front porches fool you. There's more criminals out here than in the rest of the city combined.
Are that why we're in the neighborhood?
In a way. Merle's got a dirty prosecutor on his payroll named Watkins. Turns out he's old friends with Galati.
The city councilor?
The same. Morell let drop that we might have had something to do with the Galati boy's death. Now Watkins is loaded for bear, trying to do right by his buddy. Word is, he's striking gold with a few witnesses.
You have names?
Yeah. But Paulie and Sam are taking care of them. I'm putting you on a different part of the job. We need whatever Watkins has got on us.
Well, where's he holding?
A safe in his villa.
I'm no safe cracker.
Don't worry about that. We're taking you to meet Salvatore. He's fresh off the boat, but he knows how to pop open anything. Just get him into the villa, find the safe, and he'll do the rest.
What kind of rumpus should I expect?
Nothing you can't handle. Watkins is going to the theater, so the house should be empty except for a bit of muscle. The office is on the first floor, and Arstuli says the safe is in the wall. Once Salvatore has the safe open, grab all the evidence and get out.
That him, boss?
Yeah, that's our guy. Salvatore, tutto bene?
Sì, grazie, Don Salieri.
Good to see you. You know the job. Don't let me down.
Sì, ho capisco.
Tommy, if you bump into Watkins, don't kill him. It'll just bring down more heat.
You got it, boss.
Buona fortuna, ragazzi.
Tommy Angelo. Piacere di conoscerti.
Meraviglioso. Per favore.
Parli almeno un po' di italiano? Il capo ti ha detto il piano?
I don't speak Italian.
Eccellente. Ah, fantastico. No plan?
Yeah, the boss told.
Please. Understand. Entriamo dal labirinto senza farci sentire né vedere. La cassaforte è dietro un dipinto al primo piano. Dammi un po' di tempo e lascia fare tutto a me. quella cassaforte avrà sicuramente un allarme.
Yeah. This is gonna be a long night for the both of us.
Ah, Cristo Santo.
Okay, my turn. Do what I do. Do not get caught.
Sì.
You gotta keep safe.
Safe? Sì. It's my job. Apro cassaforte. Open safe.
Christ. Okay. Radio. Let's listen to the radio.
Eccellente.
Hell of a view up here.
A volte questo paese è stupendo. Ecco. Entriamo da lì.
Over. Wall. Labirinto.
What?
Vedrà.
Che stai aspettando?
Oh. A maze.
Sì. Un labirinto.
Stay here while I take out the guards.
A quanto pare in America hanno i labirinti.
I guess.
Sure wish I could have a night off. I wish I could have a night off.
There's some...
I think that's all of them.
Salvatore! Where are you? We're clear.
Tommy! I hear!
Where the hell did he go?
Sono qui, Tommy!
Guy's a pain in the ass.
Forza! Vieni con me! Tommy! I hear!
Sei un tipo tosto, eh?
What?
C'è un'entrata. Open. Kick.
What kind of luck picker are you?
Look for a dipinto.
What?
Da Vinci, Caravaggio, hai capito?
Painting? You're saying it's behind the painting?
Sì, sì.
Okay, I understand.
Non quello.
Guess we got another room to check. Wall behind here. There's one.
Niente.
Help us!
Get out before things go bad for you. Another here, Salvatore. Nothing again.
c'è un altro dipinto. Non quello.
Delightful. Mm-hmm.
Here. Oh, burglars! Oh, help! We need help in here!
You sure it's behind one of these, Salvatore?
Scusa.
Sure. Show me what you can do. Shit. Be quick, Salvatore.
Pacienza, pacienza.
Doesn't matter. Come on, we need to get out of here.
Vai dietro, dietro.
Upstairs. The safe's in his study.
Salvatore, stay back! I'll deal with him.
Take it cover! Got it. Get him! Gotcha now! You're gonna burn!
Thank you.
Got him!
I get you first time.
Forza! Andiamocene!
I know! Whatever you're saying, I know!
Police? Cristo Santissimo!
All cars, pursuit is called off. Abandon search and return.
Grazie a Dio.
Salvatore, where do I take you now?
Home.
Yeah, we're home.
Six and Naples.
Okay, let's go.
Good night.
Night.
This is the last of the good stuff, boss.
I know. Some of those bottles I've had for 10 years. But we gotta make payroll. Get it out of here.
I've heard him. Load it up.
Good to see you, boys.
Boss, any word on a job I pulled with Salvatore?
You did fine, Tom. Galati's got nothing on us now. We bought some time. At least until the money runs out.
Don't go selling off the farm yet, boss.
Sam says you worked out an angle.
Yeah. And you're gonna love it. We make a few bucks and knock out a couple of Morello's teeth, too.
Okay, what's the rumpus?
A couple of weeks ago, I'm relaxing in the cigar lounge at the Blue Tropics.
Where?
Some small-time whorehouse. It's just a couple of closets with some mattresses on the floor.
It's a gentleman's club. They got a bar and everything. Anyways, one of the Johns is south. And he's crying to the madam about all his troubles. He catches my ear on account of his goofy accent. He's going on and on about how he just landed this huge payday. But the goons he's working for are already twisting his arm. And he's got the busted nose to show for it.
You pick up his tab?
Hell no. But I walked him out of the place, took him to the diner around the corner to sober up. We get to talking. Turns out his name is Gates. He's this hick. Up from Kentucky.
Moonshiner?
Better. His pop's got a couple of real distilleries, and I'll give you one guess as to their exclusive buyer around these parts.
Morello.
And you think he wants to burn bridges?
Oh, yeah. I've been working him steady, boss. He's bringing up another shipment tonight, but he's got his entire crew ready to roll over. All we gotta do is make it look like a proper heist.
I don't know, Polly. You really trust this guy?
He's got no love for Morello, I'll tell you that. Not like we got a lot of options here. We'll be cutting up the last beam pretty soon, boss.
What do you think, Tom?
We need to replace the Canadian. If Polly says this Gates can do that, I'm in.
Where's the meat?
The big parking garage downtown.
Okay, do it. But you better not be playing grab-ass this time. You take Carlo and little Bill with you.
Sure thing, boss.
Once you have the truck, drive it back here.
We won't let you down, boss.
Don't make me regret giving you some time out there in the streets with the guys, Carlo.
You don't have to worry about me.
I know I don't. Tommy does that for me.
I'll keep your driver safe, boss.
Buona fortuna, boys.
Sam and little Bill said to meet him downtown. You okay, Carlo? Looking kind of like you shit yourself.
Ah, get bent.
Big moment, huh? Finally running with the pack.
Listen, I spend more time with a Don than all you've put together.
Sure, sure. Sat out on the road waiting till he's finished with his broad.
If you don't want me to come, I won't. It's fine. Boss doesn't have to know.
Nah, you're coming. The boss said you're coming. Just, you got a face like you're being taken for an airing. I don't want Gates thinking we're frails.
Why is Gates sour on Morello anyways?
First time Gates pulled in with his trucks, Morello decided to change up the terms. The big guy himself popped him in the nose as part of their renegotiation.
His nose is gonna get more than a pop if Morello hears we're involved.
That's why we're pretending to stick him up. Then he'll go back to his pop and tell a sob story about being robbed at gunpoint. He'll convince his old man that Morello can't protect the merchandise. He'll need to find a new buyer out here, and he's heard of a stand-up guy named Salieri.
This plan is some bullshit, Tom. Paulie told it to me yesterday, and somehow it's gotten worse.
Hey, when you get a lead for the boss, and you don't just drive him places, then you get to pick holes. Till then, shut your damn mouth.
Whatever helps you sleep. When Morello tracks you down, don't come crying to me.
You serious? You actually serious?
Fellas, knock it off. Christ.
Mm-hmm.
about the way I love you and adore you, my own. I've tried to speak expression.
I do a lot of deals here. Parking attendant don't ask for much dough. Always closes up shop till I'm done.
Okay, we're good. Gates is waiting up on the top floor.
Place seems clear so far.
Only people with cars are people with jobs. 9 to 5, place is deserted.
Well, we got jobs and we're here.
That kind of a job, sure.
Anything else we need to know about Gates, Polly?
Only that he's got a bust-up nose and crates full of the good stuff.
Our kind of guy.
Park up over there.
Polly! Good to see you, pal.
Yeah, you too, Gates.
Well, I hope you all have good taste in whiskey.
I ain't really the expert here. Tommy.
Oh, yeah. It's fine. Your first payment. If the Don's impressed, he'll finance more runs.
And each one's gonna be bigger than the last. We're all gonna be rich, boys.
Well, we are always happy to do business with good folks like Don Salieri. Please, give him my regards.
Sure thing. Now we just gotta conclude this transaction.
Damn it, Polly! No! It's okay.
Oh. What? I told you we gotta make it look like a proper robbery.
Damn thing's gonna be crooked by the time I'm done with this city.
Ah, don't worry, pal. All the dough you're raking in, you're gonna be able to pay for a new one.
Watch out!
No, damn it! Battle it together, Polly! God damn it!
Gates took a bullet.
And this ain't as bad as it looks. Now take the booze and get. My guys will come for me. No, go! So long as you guys clear them out up ahead, I'll be safe here with the little guy.
Carlo, in the cab with me. You know you's dead. Tommy, check for more of them. This thing ain't over.
Come on, I'll back you up.
Got more of them.
Get over here now!
That bastard,
they keep coming. Reload. They keep coming.
Thank you.
gotta be a valve to turn someplace. Their way through this fence?
Grab a set of wheels and watch my back.
Sure, Sam.
How the hell did Morello hear about my deal?
All kinds of beefers in this city. For now, let's get the booze back to the warehouse and try not to die.
I knew it! We got more guys on us!
Okay, let's slow them down some.
Hit them where it hurts! Lost them all.
Thank Christ for that. Let's head home. See what we got.
We got the booze. I mean, I know it didn't go to plan, but we got the booze.
Yeah. Though tonight, me and you are gonna drink a bunch of it.
I guess we earned that much.
Like a 38. Morello's boys caught up with you?
Yeah, boss. We took care of it.
What about the kid from Kentucky?
Well, he took a slug to the shoulder, but he's a tough blocker. He and his crew dusted out as soon as we bumped off Morello's hatchet men.
Getting shot will give Gates and his pop another reason to ice Morello out of the whiskey business.
Well, let's see if this hooch was worth all the trouble. Excellent. I'll work out the details with Papa Gates. But once we're running this Kentucky Brown, we'll be back in brass buttons. Good work, son. I'm proud of you. I'm proud of all of you. Salud!
Salud!
Sounds like Salieri was getting ready to make his move.
Working up to it, maybe. But then, Prohibition ended. And a bootlegging business got knocked on its ass. Oh, that fighting over booze meant next to nothing. It took us a few years to recover. But when we did bounce back, boy, it was something. We took what dough we had from the moonshine and Canadian whiskey and invested it into new records. Some of them even legal. Construction, restaurants, trucking, gambling. We branched out into everything, except peddling dope. By 35, things were looking up. We had good money rolling in on the regular. I had a wife and daughter. Sam was running a club for the Don. Even Pauly had a few records of his own. Wasn't exactly happy, but what do you call it?
Content.
Yeah, that was it. And Salieri, he finally starts talking about getting out of Morello's shadow. Maybe buying our own cops, our own politicians.
That's interesting. You think Salieri was sourcing highbinders in 34?
Maybe. Why?
Well, a few years back, a voice squad got a judge on solicitation of a minor. Once in the box, he started confessing all sorts of misbehaving, trying to get a deal. But he copped to taking kickbacks from Morello and your man Salieri. Playing him off one another, trying to goose the take. But once Morello found out, he threatened to bury the judge's kids on the beach. Still breathing, of course.
Christ. That was the missing piece.
How's that?
Morello was always winding us up. But he never did anything that might start an all-out war. Learning Salieri was building his own bench must have finally tipped his scales, because in 35, he hit us with both barrels. ...with his face and pasted it
hey,
on his face.
Tommy!
Oh, hey, boss. What's going on?
I'm glad you're here.
There you go, boss.
I'm going to Pepe's for lunch, but Carlo called in sick. You up for a drive?
Sure, boss.
Bravo. I'm already starving. You got a piece on you?
Yeah. You think I'll need it?
You know how it is. Things with Morello have been a little quiet lately. Maybe it's just got me jumpy is all. So how's business, Tom?
You know how it is. It's good.
Sure, I know the business. I see the books every day. But since what happened, I know that a capo needs to talk to his soldiers without some other guy getting in the way.
And Great Britain. And now, back to WBDS, broadcasting live.
I guess we're mixing with a better sort of person, though. And I like dealing with all these big shots we got on the pad. Anything's better than those grifters trying to shift their hooch before the 21st went through.
Ah, this is only the start of it, Tom. I got plans. Plenty of good people lining up for a slice.
Glad to hear it.
Be nice for you. Some time away from Polly and his cockamamie schemes.
That's better conversation, boss. I'll give you that.
Sure I am.
Me, Sam, and Polly, though, we're still real tight. We've been through some times together.
Yeah, don't I know it.
More wine here, please, quickly. You're going to love this wine. It's a... Don Salieri! Welcome, my friend, welcome.
Good to see you, Pepe.
Yes. Hey, come. Our guest has arrived, eh?
What's on the menu today?
My mother, she would be so honored if you tried her caponata.
Excellent. Bravo, bravo.
Oh, Benny, let me get you a chair for you, huh? Si, please. And to drink a Chianti. I've been saving this just for you.
Yeah, bene, bene, bene.
Enjoy, huh?
I'm glad you're off the roof, Tom.
Sarah threatened to leave me if I didn't dry out.
I know.
She told you.
No. I put her up to it. Drunkards get sloppy, Tom. I didn't want you to make a mistake we couldn't live with.
For you? And for you.
Pepe, the meal is a masterpiece as always.
Molto grazie, Don Salieri. Praise from such a gourmet as you, it filled me with joy.
You wouldn't call me a gourmet if you knew what I had for supper.
Get down!
Let me finish my wine.
Hey, Salieri! Come out of there and we'll make this quick.
Smoke them out, Joe.
Shit, watch out!
Going out the front door. Can you move?
Not fast enough. We're gonna ambush these boys. I'll keep them entertained while you slip out the back and circle around.
You sure, boss?
Blow them all down, Tommy.
Not one of them goes home tonight.
Okay, boss. Be careful.
Tom, just be quick about it.
Take them out, Tom. Go!
Down to me! Come and get me, you sons of bitches!
Boss, I got this! Try to keep your head down!
Get him!
Look at the balls on this kid. You really saved my ass, Tom.
We gotta go, boss. The cops will be here soon.
I need a minute to catch my breath.
Well, let me get you back to the bar.
No, not the bar. We're going to see Carlo. That son of a bitch knew where I was going today, and he calls in sick.
He set you up.
To us, Tom, you could have ended up just as dead.
Yeah, I know, boss.
Carlo's jacked up with some dame in Holbrook. Let's go see what he has to say about all this. Step on it, Tom. Every minute Carlo's still breathing is a minute that's got me pissed.
Sure, boss.
Can't believe these bastards had the brass balls to wreck my car. Had to be Carlo, didn't it? His pop was tight with Morello right when we started out. Apple don't fall far from the tree, huh? I wept at his funeral. At his sons, I'll be laughing loud. His mom's already a widow, Tom, and now he's gonna make her lonely till the day she dies. For what? Some dough to buy his dope? And my foot through his face. Know what? I'm glad. I'm glad this happened. I get to plug another rat, and we finally go to the mattresses with Morello. Today's the day the dam breaks.
Sure feels like it.
You take a guy in, you give him a place in your family, you give him respect, and this is how he repays you?
If he's done this, what else has he squealed on? The farm, the betting house, the ambush at the parking garage, any of them could have been him.
Jesus Christ, someone's been ratting us out to Morello for years, and the time we work it out is when his guys come this close to bumping me off?
Thank you.
Vice, why don't you let me go first, huh? Carlo might be waiting for us.
No, Tom. My face is going to be the first and last thing this bastard sees.
What the fuck?
You goddamn dirty grifter.
You better dangle, sweetheart.
It's gonna be a closed casket, Carlo.
You okay, Buzz?
Yeah, just a little one. Let me catch my breath.
Jesus, he's fast for a big guy.
Don't let him get away!
Help! Help me, someone!
Come back here, Carlo!
You're going to kill me!
Hey, we ain't finished with you!
Tommy, please! I can explain! Think about this now! Please! Let me talk to the boss! I can explain everything! Tommy, you gotta know! Carlo, he was gonna kill Mom! I had to do it! I had to! They made me do it, Tommy! Please, I can explain.
There's only so many rules in this life. You.
Is he still alive?
I'm not sure.
How are you? Keeping out of trouble?
Sure. Who's this? Wait a minute. Is that Gordy? It is. Hey, Gordy, how you doing, buddy? Hardly recognized you. What'd he do?
You said you were having some trouble down at the docks, right?
Yeah. It's nothing I can't handle.
Yeah, well, I did some asking around. This asshole was planning a strike. Strikes are no good for business. Unless you don't want to call them for it, right?
Right.
So I decided the union needed a little change in leadership. Is that all right with you?
Of course.
Yeah. Now, what about that other thing?
That's why I'm here. Salieri's still alive.
God damn it! What happened?
I don't know yet. Crew we sent is dead. Restaurant's all shot to hell.
Stop your crying. Trying to have a conversation here. What about the cockroach Carlo?
Found him with his head smashed in like a fucking watermelon. Never seen anything like it.
So they already must have figured Carlo was the rat. God damn it. Can't even hear myself think.
It's gonna be a war.
I told you to shut the fuck up! We've been at war since you killed Papone. It's just out in the open now.
What do you want me to do?
Make your rounds. Tell little boys to keep their eyes peeled and their powder dry.
Okay. Put the word out.
Hey. Just, keep your head down, little brother.
You too, Don Morello.
We're at the start of something. Something big.
You think?
Morello tried to kill...
Hey, you're needed up the stairs. I'll go straight up. It's war, Tom. From today, we are at war.
Haven't seen any trouble just yet.
Hey, it true that Don slipped Carlo the bump, not you?
Yeah. It wasn't pretty.
Still blood in his veins, huh?
Lesson, Carlos.
Keeping out of trouble, I hope.
I want guards and lookouts around the clock. Here, the warehouse, and all our businesses.
How about people under our protection? Forget-
our guy's in place.
Good.
We're finally going after him.
Soon. But first we have to soften him up. Morell's got the cops, the politicians, and even some judges in his pocket. We can't afford to bite them all off, so we need to scare them into abandoning Morell's sinking ship.
We bump off the right idiot, the rest are going to realize sticking with Morello ain't too good for their health.
First in line for the pine box is this asshole, Galati. The counts are still seeing red over his dead kid, so he's never going to turn on Morello.
Christ, that guy's been giving us fits since 32. Let me take care of him, boss.
Why do you think you're here? Then he's got it all figured out.
The counselor is celebrating his birthday with a big shindig on a steamboat. He's pulling out all the stops. Booths, broads, fireworks. He's even giving a speech to the press.
What kind of security?
Just in normal detail, a few guys with Roscoe's. None of the other fellas are gonna do dick to protect that piece of shit.
Okay. I'll talk my way into the party, put two in his head.
Slow down, Junior. Galati's corrupt, but he ain't stupid. His crew be searching everyone who comes on board, so you can't be caring.
So, what? Throw him overboard, see if he can swim.
Don't go getting creative on me. You're still going to shoot him, for fuck's sake. When you get on deck, you make for the head. We got a janitor on the take, and he's planted a revolver in the bathroom.
And then you just cool your heels. Mingle. Try not to look like a hatchet man until Galati makes his appearance. You wait for that bastard to start his speech, and only then do you put one between his eyes.
We want it done in public to get people talking.
Sure. But you got a plan for getting back to shore?
Sam and Paulie are down the docks working on that. You meet up with them there, and they'll fill you in on the rest of the details.
Okay. Galati's done, boss. You won't have to worry about him after tonight.
I don't doubt it, Tommy.
Buona fortuna, Tom.
Delivered earlier this year. This is part of our series looking back over the president's plans and results since his inauguration.
Our responsibility is to all of the people in this country. This is a great national crusade, a crusade to destroy forced idols, which is an enemy of the human spirit generated by this depression. Our attack upon these enemies must be without stint and without discrimination. No sectional, no political distinctions can be permitted. It must, however, be recognized, and I know you will recognize it, that when an enterprise of this character is extended over more than 3,100 counties throughout the nation,
Attention, folks, attention. We'll get you all aboard, but we will need to see tickets.
The finest family in the city.
No doubt in my mind. Who's done more?
And all this up to the bosses.
He's gonna clear up this city.
Terrence! You got an invite too?
You don't look like a guy with an invite.
I got friends. Just not these kind of friends.
Well, I'll tell you what I got. Sailor back there who works on the steamer. His head, it's something heavy. But his dandy white suit's fine.
Thanks. I'll go find him.
I know you'd get a real job someday. So remember, play it cool. When you've gone some ways over the water, find the gun. The janitor stashed it in the bathroom.
Sure.
Then get up on the roof. Wait for Galati's speech and pop him when he's done.
How do I get away?
Polly's borrowed a speedboat. After the speech, there's fireworks. We'll come as soon as we...
You better be there on time.
Don't worry. It'll go smooth like eggs and coffee.
Looking good, Tom. The outfit don't get messed up. Keep it. Suits you.
You the new guy? Christ, you took your time.
You think he's gonna pull this off?
He sure as shit gonna kill Galati. Getting off that boat? Well, he's gonna need a guardian angel.
He don't need no fucking angel. He's got us looking out for him.
Hey, you almost done?
Yeah. Was gonna go clean the bathrooms. Heard some guests complaining.
You're volunteering to clean toilets? Whatever. I got a rag there. Check every deck.
Don't I know you from someplace?
Nah, don't think so.
I swear I know you. Were you with the Union, maybe?
Sorry, buddy. I'm from out of town.
I can't believe I got an invite.
Drink's still done, the guy said.
Seen the janitor any place?
Nah, but if I had to put money on it,
drunk in the engine room.
Gun in the jam in the stern. Mid deck.
Where's stern?
Next floor up. Right above us. Keys on the table there.
You ever say my name again, and you'll be found floating outside. Get that?
Yeah, I get that.
What are you gonna do about it?
Well, I'm gonna give you a beat for starters.
Putting you down!
Jesus!
Hey, John. Hope you're enjoying yourself.
As long as the bar stays open, counselor.
Good man. Have another for me, huh?
Good to see you. Thanks for coming.
Hey, thank you, everyone. Yeah, thank you. Hey, welcome to my little party, right? So, as you all know, it has been a tough time. 3 years ago, my dear son, Billy, left us. An innocent pawn in a deadly gang war. A victim of the deceased, that is, organized crime. Since that day, I have lived only to eradicate this disease. Today is a day for celebration for my 50th birthday. And for a brighter future for lost heaven. The criminals will be driven out of town. They'll drown like rats in the water. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. And now for the fireworks, huh?
Reload!
bad.
I'm getting out of here.
Find the cover. Got it.
Faster! I'm lower!
nothing could be worse, huh? We could be peeling you off the front of the train.
He just got a good break, is all.
Sergio Morella's always been lucky. He was born with more brains than his brother, that's for sure.
We'll get him, boss.
No, you tore off this job. You're broken mirrors on this one. We'll let the guy who killed Galati take a crack. Tommy here's got all the politicians scared. Maybe he can put Sergio in the ground.
What do I need to know about this guy?
Besides, he's got a lucky rabbit's foot up his ass.
Sergio is Morello's top earner. He controls the unions, which means he controls the docks and attacks everything that's imported into the city. We kill him, and a big part of Morello's income will be wiped out.
Any ideas on how to get to him? I don't want to end up in a tree like these two.
You're going to scatter his ashes. It's a custom job. Attach it to the starter under his car, he'll be a human torch as soon as he turns the key.
It's safe to carry.
Yeah, just don't drop it. Shake it, smoke near it. Yeah, it's safe. Boom!
Get it done, Tommy. For all our guys Morello's killed. And for all the money he's taken out of our pockets.
I'll take care of it, boss.
There's no way they'd come here.
I used to run with his crew. If Morello wakes up one morning and wants to come heavy, he'll come heavy.
Nah, now he won't.
He goes with his gut. There's one thing he's got, it's gut.
He'd see all of Little Italy burn.
To the ground.
From the news desk of WLH 570, a special report on crime in our city. It had been hoped by lawmakers and the general public alike that the end of Prohibition would cut off the mob's air supply. But 2 years since the repeal of the 18th Amendment, it seems to have merely added fuel to the conflagration of crime that engulfs the country. It would appear that removing the conditions that created a new type of virulent gangsterism is not going to remove the problem. The criminal empire.
But need some help. Anyone down in the works corner? Reports of a speeding driver.
Are simply too powerful, too deep rooted to simply be swept away. The more established of these organizations are consolidating their power. The competition between them continues to bring violence.
That'll do nicely.
That'll be good for the beers tonight. Kind of shifty looking.
Don't let
isn't
me
he?
See you do that again, huh?
All right.
Ticket issued. Go back to your patrols.
The corrupt politician or the dirty cop is the facilitator, and both roles must be played for organized crime to flourish. I've heard it mentioned in certain newspapers that the upward trajectory of the economy would quell the mob's opportunities to exploit police and lawmakers. That, sadly, doesn't appear to be the case. Those engaged in corruption are not doing so to put food on the table. City officials and public servants earn more than most, and did so even at the height of the Depression. So that, frankly, does not wash. Plenty of people far worse off live without sin. As we have seen in Lost Heaven, standing up to the mob can be a dangerous game. Suspected mob hits carried out against officials in a number of American cities attest to that. What are our state and federal governments doing to ease public concerns? What can we expect from J. Edgar Hoover and his BOI, now renamed the Federal Bureau of Investigations? Are we truly powerless in the face of such callous disregard for human life? We shall let you know if we ever receive answers to these questions. This concludes our special report. Scheduled music programs and regular news bulletins brought to you by Lost Heaven Radio.
Sergio's car. How am I gonna get through to it?
You lost?
Yeah, I'll be home before supper. Hey, you want to go dancing this weekend? Maybe drop the kid off at your pop's place. Yeah, I'm still here. Oh, Christ.
Hey! Stop!
No. Vinny, it all went bad.
Hey, pull it together, Tom. Whatever happened, happened. There's nothing you can do about it now. Sergio's luck is running out.
What are you talking about?
Sam and Paulie have found him. He's in Georgie's restaurant across town. You need to get over there fast.
Okay.
The chief of police admits his men have yet to apprehend any suspects in the brazen public assassination of city councilor Roberto Gilotti. Gilotti was gunned down while giving a speech at his own birthday party aboard the paddle steamer Lost Heaven Queen. According to eyewitness reports, the assassin made a daring escape by motorboat, aided by a number of associates, all under the cover of a lavish fireworks display. The public nature of the slaying, as well as the degree of professionalism with which it was carried out, have led some to speculate that Gilotti was the latest public servant to become a victim of the epidemic of mob violence currently in...
Tom, you okay?
Yeah, this is a car bomb. Things went south.
We could draw about it later. Right now, we gotta get that bastard. Let's go.
What the hell?
We got a message from Mr. Salieri.
No! Kill these clowns!
Man, what?
Get me out of here!
Motherfucker!
Oh, he's gone!
Go get him, Tommy!
Come on! Let's get back to the car. We gotta catch up before that idiot gets himself killed!
Idiots doing? Kill that motherfucker!
We got down here now!
See him! He's coming this way! Get him off my ass!
Come on!
Coming this way!
Yeah.
Pay you for? He's tearing the docks apart!
Hey! Over here!
You're out of here! Got him.
Now I see ya.
Train? Found him!
Follow me while I reload!
Burn him! Molotov! Quick here!
Thank you.
kill me, my brother will destroy everything you know. Come on, let's finish this. Just winged me, asshole! You think you're the guy who's gonna kill me? What did I tell you? No one can touch me.
You ain't that lucky, bastard.
Wait. No!
After we killed Sergio, it was chaos for weeks. Our guys against their guys, and Morello gone to ground. But a boss can't stay hidden forever. For a Don to be feared, he's gotta be seen. Finally, word came through that he was gonna break cover.
Morello wants to thumb his nose at us. Taking a show like there's not a war on, we'll meet him in the streets.
We do him like this. We wait outside the theater till the end of the show. All those rich assholes will start coming out. That's when we hit Morello and his gorillas. In a crowd. Before they see us coming.
The theater's going to be packed. And not just with saps. There's a good chance the mayor, maybe even the chief, might be there too.
That's the goddamn point, Tom. We kill Morello in public. In front of the city's creme de la creme. Then they'll all know who's in charge. And it doesn't matter if you have a badge or a gavel or a fat wad of cash in your pocket. If you cross Salieri and his boys, you're dead.
Okay, boss. We'll get it done.
Take the machine guns. Make sure you don't draw attention to yourselves hanging around outside the theater. You keep the choppers hidden until you spot Morello.
And then you light them up. I want it to look like that white suit is covered in roses. You got it?
Sure, boss.